All right, guys, final story of this week. There is another hoax hate crime. In this case, a 12-year-old girl in Virginia claimed that three white classmates had held her down on the playground and forcibly cut off her dreadlocks. This story was blasted all over national media, particularly for the fact that Second Lady Karen Pence is teaching an art class at the school. So, of course, this story turned into, well, Karen Pence is working at a racist school, and therefore Trump is bad, orange man racist, blah, 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 blah. Classic media narrative. Turns out, however, that the girl made the whole thing up. She actually cut the dreadlocks off herself. The boys never held her down. Video evidence proves that this incident was, in fact, a hoax. But there needs to be more attention on the local news reporter who first grabbed a hold of this story. Her name is Makia Turner. She's a TV reporter in Washington, D.C. She had this young girl on her show a half a dozen times talking about how this is proof that there need to be anti-discrimination laws against women with dreadlocks. And as it turns out, this TV reporter has been an advocate for such a law for a very long time. It's her political advocacy project is advocating for a natural hair law that would prevent discrimination against dreadlocks. She also apparently had this young girl's family on her show before to push for their company called Still Natural that sells beauty products to help women with natural hair and dreadlocks take care of it. So she has a connection to the family and obviously a vested political interest in a hate crime like this. And she was the one who was elevating this girl into the national media landscape. And then, of course, when the story turned out to be false, Makia Turner deleted all of her old articles and then merely issued a short correction, not even naming the girl, even though she was already shown on TV a bunch of times. So it seems to me that people should try to find out whether or not this TV reporter knew that it was a hoax before she ran with it, or if she merely ignored the fishy things about this story because she wanted to be able to use it for her political efforts. But those of us who have been following these hoax hate crimes for a while now, whether it's Jussie Smollett or these cases where people claim there are swastikas drawn on churches and then it turns out it was actually a black man, not a white MAGA hat wearing individual, they know, they see a story like this and they automatically know to be skeptical, and they obviously can kind of guess what's going to be a hoax now because the demand for these hate crimes is so much higher than the supply. And so people have to make them up to keep pushing this narrative that we're living in this bigoted society.